Hi, I'm Exact Weather meteorologist Jay Gallet, and thanks for logging on to your afternoon video cast. Let's take a look outside Harris River camera, and you can see the development of a little bit of cloud cover out there. We are looking at about a 40% chance of rain. So as we continue moving through the afternoon, we'll continue to see the clouds bubbling up. Let me show you your exact cast headline. So scattered showers and storms are possible today, and then through the weekend, we'll keep a 20 to 30% chance of rain, though, as we get to Saturday and Sunday. It'll be warm, a little humid, and we are continuing to track Isaac as he makes his way through the Caribbean. Yesterday's high staying below that average, 87 was the high. There's your average, 91, and we'll be ducking below that average for the next few days as we take a look at the Saturday. Satellite and radar imagery, disturbance right here moving into the northern portion of Texas. Also another disturbance here in Canada. That's going to be moving across the map. As it does so, that's what's going to create the weakness we've been talking about that's going to impact Tropical Storm Isaac's path as it starts moving over. The question is the timing and the strength of the trough versus the ridge. Let me show you what's going on out in the tropics. We've got a couple of areas that are still holding on to about a 30% chance. That is a medium chance. This is still off the coast of Africa. And Joyce has now become a remnant low, so not going to get any more forecast advisories on Joyce. Here is Tropical Storm Isaac. As you can see, getting a little better organized. Winds have increased, moving to the west right now at about 12 to 15 miles per hour. We'll first check out the spaghetti plots. It'll cross Haiti, then it'll make its way across Cuba. As it does, it's going to have a hard time becoming a hurricane, although as it ducks right here in between Haiti and Cuba, it could bump up to a Category 1 hurricane, but it'll quickly diminish due to its interaction with Cuba. Then it's going to impact parts of the Florida Keys, maybe nicking southwestern Florida, and then it will start making landfall. Look at this. The path has shifted a little bit more toward the east. Looks like it's going to be making landfall somewhere between Fort Walton Beach and Panama City with this one outlier model right here, the H-Wurf. It is an outlier, although the cone of uncertainty, as you'll see here, does extend through southeastern Louisiana. So here we go. 60 mile per hour max sustained winds moving to the west-northwest at about 14. So it has begun to make that turn to the right. By Saturday, 65 mile per hour max sustained winds. Then it will be crossing Cuba. It'll lose some strength, dropping to 50 miles per hour. And as we get into the southeastern Gulf of Mexico, 65 miles per hour. Now, the Gulf is plenty, plenty warm. As a result, we could see Isaac becoming a little bit more than a Category 1 storm. That's why attention must be paid, as well as this path. It's been fluctuating a whole lot, and notice the cone of uncertainty does extend past southeast Louisiana and southern Mississippi. So once again, as you make your way through your weekend festivities, keep an eye on Isaac, because this path will most likely continue to adjust. Here's a forecast model for today. Like I said, about a 40% chance of rain by 7 o'clock. We'll lose some of the scattered showers and a couple of thunderstorms will pick up. And in the overnight hours, we'll clear it out. For today, upper 80s, lower 90s, scattered showers and storms, partly to mostly cloudy, a little bit on the warm side, and then mostly clear overnight tonight. A couple of spots like Houma may dip into the upper 60s, everyone else in the mid to upper 70s. And your 7-day exact cast is showing that we'll drop your rain chances to 30% on Saturday, 20 on Sunday, and we'll hold steady with a 20% chance of rain as we move through next Tuesday and Wednesday. Of course, that may be adjusted depending upon the eventual track of Isaac and its proximity to southeastern Louisiana and southern Mississippi. I'm Exact Weather meteorologist Jay Gallet, and thanks for logging on.